Welcome back to another episode of Carpe Madness. But a new venue this time, Water Meadows, Carp Fishery, down near Crewkerne or in Crewkerne or around that area. Got some lodges here as well, so there's a little lodges and a little 1.5 acre lake. Really, really weedy, that's what I'm saying. Really weedy. Here on the social with the boys, and I got here last, got here about 3 o'clock. Six swims on the lake, so obviously three of them were taken. So I had three pegs to choose from, so I walked around two or three times with the old Polaroids on, it was sunny. I've seen a lot of fish on the surface, to be fair. You got one end which is like 4 foot, 3 foot shallow, and the other end which is like 6 foot deep, 7 foot, something like that, I think, and it is weedy. So I ended up choosing the shallows in the end. Most of the boys were in the deep end. I thought with them casting out, leading around, the fish would be a bit spooked off. Obviously I come here, bought the old bait boat, and I just slowly cruise it out, stealthy, not casting the lead, drop my rigs off, and hopefully where they've been spooking the fish pushes it up my ends, to be fair. All I've done, drive the boat around for like half hour, quick lap around, a little swim on a deeper, everywhere's weedy, 4 or 5 foot of water, and the weed's probably about a foot to 2 foot everywhere. So I've literally drove the boat around, found a nice little spot where it's about a foot of weed, like the smallest bit of weed I could find, basically. Dropped the old rigs on it. Got both of them on the old HeliSafe system, tubing and a bead right at the top, so it's about 2 foot of movement for the rig. PVA nugget on the old rig. So as soon as the bait boat lets go, the lead plummets down into the weed. LP vein nugget will hold the rig up, and as soon as that goes, got a waft on a Ronnie on him, it will just flutter down, sit on top of the weed nicely, and you've got a big bed of bait around the area as well. Hopefully we bag a fish, you know. Got the old rods on the dance floor, time's 6 o'clock now, just about to get dark. So yeah, and we'll see what tonight brings, hopefully a fish. Morning guys, what a morning it is as well. Sun absolutely beaming down. Time's 7 o'clock as we speak. Rudely got woken up by the old swan. Right over there he is. Don't know if you've seen the old camera. Obviously I'm only fishing like 4 foot of water. This is the shallow end of the lake. So yeah, 4 foot of water. The weeds on the deepest end, about a foot, foot and a half, 2 foot max. Obviously with the HeliSafe system I'm using, it's sat on top of 2 foot of weed. So the swans can easily get his head down. He woke me up at 6:30 this morning. Absolutely mucking around, wind bobbing, beeping it was. Rushed out, got out of bed, you know how it is. Think you got a fish on, buzzing. Next thing you know, looked out, it's a fucking swan. My man absolutely taking the mick out. So all I did then was got a few doggies, got a big bag of them, and I just started chucking them in the margin, just here. Here he is, look, big dog. Started chucking them in the margin, making him feed there, basically, so he gets off my spot. So yeah, as he's mucking about with me rigs and that, decided to reel in both rods. So I kept the same hook baits as I used last night. One on the wafter, soaked in spicy squid goo from Corder, and the other one on the pop-up, soaked in the garlic goo from Corder as well. So yeah, after I reeled in, I drove the old bait boat around for half hour, the whole swim, basically, and the whole swim, sort of managed to map out the lake. And all I've really done is find a few spot with less weed, as such. I haven't really felt a let down or nothing, so I'm guessing they're clear spots or like a little, not even a foot of weed in it really. So yeah, after I've done that, found two nice spots. One just under the tree over there, which is on my left hand rod, so I decided to put the old garlic pop up on it, on the old Ronnie rig. And on my right, near the tree again, but probably like two rod lengths towards me and a bit to the right, and I put the old spicy squid wafter on that one. So yeah, we'll see how the day goes and we'll go from there. It's only gone and melted off, hasn't it? Right hand rods, absolutely melted off. Time's about 8:30 now. Gonna get the old carp cradle set up, put it in the old sling quickly for 5 minutes, and get her weighed up. I'll see you when I got the fish on the bank. Yeah, buddy. Done the recast this morning, 7 o'clock. Woke up early, got the boat out at a different spot this time. And it's absolutely melted off. Walked down to the other swim quickly just to see my mate. Absolutely melted, absolutely immaculate it is. So we're just gonna get her up, show you her, and we'll go from there. Oh, fuck's sake. So yeah, here she is. 17.4 mirror, immaculate. Beautiful dark thing, look at the scales on that. Look at the colours too. To show you the other side, and we'll get her back ASAP. Here's the other side. Immaculate, same again. Beautiful fish this, dark as hell. Buzzing to be off the mark. So yeah, over the moon. Get her back, get some stills, and we'll go for one there. One in the bank. Time's 1 o'clock now. Beaming down the sun is. Be honest with you, I don't think you're going to be feeding on the bottom on this one. Absolutely scorchio. Gone the old see my old mate in the swim down from me, old Davidoff. And be fair, all cruising on the surface. It's a nice little orange fish in it, which looks bang on, to be fair. So yeah, going to reel in, make some grub, have a little mooch around and a walk, see what's going on. And redo the rods. No further action as such. Obviously had that one little fish this morning. Get in there, my son. Just see what today brings. Hopefully another cuttlefish on the bank. Hopefully one of the boys has one. Get them on the old video as well. But yeah, we'll see how today goes and we'll go from there. Just gonna show the mix we've been putting out today. So I've got the old micro pellet, all different sizes, and brown bait, bit of krill on. Shove a bit of that in there. We also put in the big pellet, so that's like 6, 8, 10 mil pellet. A few scoops in, mate. He's just turned the aerator on. Then using the old bigot boilies again, a squid and octopus look. I don't know if you see that. And the old krill and garlic, the old quarter cutter. Just chop them in there like that. Beautiful, beautiful. Look, a few of them. I don't know, just a few arse, I don't know, probably about. That's 6 at a time, this cutter, so that's probably 18 there, look. Ish. And I also get the old boilies again. Put them in the crusher, crush them up, and a couple, probably about 30 boilies max. Get the old sticky krill glug, pure krill extract, and pure tuna extract, whatever is from sticky. Big squeeze that goes in. Don't be scared, like I said last time, to use this. It does come in litre bowls. Big squeeze out. Big old extra. Basically, I just want it glazed. Don't want it too much. So, like, like glazing. So yeah, there you go, a whole load of cart goodness. Put it in the boat and we go from there. So yeah, here goes, bon voyage. Titanic, ready to sink. Perfect in that little spot I wanted to be in, to be fair. So yeah, just gonna send the other rod out now. Fishing in like a four foot bit of water. The weed's probably about a foot, so it's the clearest spot I can see on the deeper. So I had that fish earlier, and it's going back there. So send the boat out, and she goes again. Right, that fish will probably just on that spot, so I will take my time with it. Little swan likes me as well. I think it was there, to be fair. The old Titanic didn't hit an iceberg. And we're fishing. Spins for luck. It's like Robot Wars, this. The old maiden voyage is back. Little update, guys. The old time's 8 o'clock. Absolutely pitch black everywhere. Got rats bothering me like hell. Climbing on the old bivvy, everything. One was on there, absolutely hit it, mate. He must have gone flying. But yeah, like I say, all I've done today is literally just redo the rods. Right hand rod where I had that fish. So left hand rod on the old Ronnie. I put right up in the margin. Probably about 3 meters from my swim. There's a little overhanging tree. And a nice little clear patch, probably size of two bin lids put together. And all I've done is literally drive the boat in there, drop it off, and to be fair, it's under an overhanging tree, so you can climb the overhanging tree. So you can climb the overhanging tree, look down, you can see me little yellow Mystic Spice pop up, my right one. I switched up to a pink krill one, the new goof on caller that is. Hopefully it absolutely melts off again and we get another one. Don't get me wrong, it would be nice to have another one, but I'm not worried as such because I've had the one. And yeah, get me head down, get some munch again, a bit of coffee. And hopefully we're greeted with another minter. Right, guys, just reeled the rods in. And while I've got them in, just gonna show you the rigs and bits I've been using, to be fair. Some weed on that, look, they're reeled in. So start from the lead end, heli-safe lead that is, and weedy green. Got a heli-safe system there, look. And I've got 2 foot of tungsten putty. It's about 2 foot, 2.5 foot. And on the end of that putty, I've got a bead there, which enables the rig to slide up and down. And then the rig end, the old German rig that is, starting from the hook end. Got a micro ring swivel, hook stop, and a size 6 barbless, because it's barbless rule here, a Fox medium curve. That's German rig, so it's basically a knotless knot with no hair, basically. So you cut the hair. I got a length of 6-inch Fox tungsten Cortex. Then about, I don't know, about a finger length, probably about 1.5-2 centimeters. Then got an Avid extra large rig drop, so you don't have to use that. I just think it looks neater, but you can put a bit of putty there instead. And that, all that does is actually pull the hook when it's in the mouth, pull the hook into the mouth. And got a anti-tangle sleeve, probably about 35mm I think that is, onto a quick flexi quick change swivel. And what I do before I chuck it out and put it in the boat or whatever is such, get your PVA nugget, make sure the hook bait's at the top, like such, like that look. All that does, when the lead plummets into the wee buff like that, that PVA nugget will stay at the top in the water like that. Obviously it's got a 2 foot movement, so that'll plummet into the weed. PVA nugget will float to the top of the bead, of the tubing where the bead is. When the PVA nugget comes off, it slowly flutters back down on top of the weed basically. So if you imagine there, for example, you're in a foot of weed, lead's there, in a foot of weed. PVA nuggets come off and that's just sitting on top of a weed look. Where I'm putting it in the boat and dropping it, the boilies and the pellet and that will sit on the weed as well on the top, because I'm not casting or spotting, it just flutters down and that will just sit on top of it. So nice pink, bright, so you can see it over the old freebies I'm giving them. This is the one that done the damage with that beautiful dark mirror. Switched back to the German rig a couple weeks ago. To be fair, it's been bang on. So yeah, just gonna get this one out and I'll show you the other rig. Just show you my left arm rod now, the other rig I've been using. Exactly the same setup again, HeliSafe system. But this time I put a little tungsten sink on there look. And then the bead goes over that. I didn't have enough tubing. The weed's a bit longer, so I've just upped the bead, so it's still for safety. As you can see, it does exactly the same job, look. Plummets in weed that have come over that. But yeah, rig end. Got a size 11 flexi quick chain swivel. Just allows it to go over the tubing and up and down. A 35mm anti-tangle sleeve, 6 inches of Fox Cortex tungsten again. That's the boom. A little bit of putty there. And the old Ronnie rig for the old Mystic Spice pop-up. Then again, all I do that, I leak the PVA. Put it over the hook. So it sits nice like that. Same concept again. Leather plummet into the weed, PVA nugget, make the Ronnie rig float to the top. As soon as it's off, it will slide down on top of the weed with a few freebies over the top. So yeah, this one ain't had nothing, the old Mystic Spicy. The other one, Spicy Squid Wafter, German rig, bang on. Slowly packed down basically. Get this one back out and we go from there. Right, ladies and gents, coming up 12 o'clock now, it's me done. I want to get out of here, to be fair, hour drive home. But until then, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, leave a comment. And what a minter that fish was. I'll see you on the next episode of Carping Madness.